Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee on KUHS Radio TV Denver.
Yes, indeedy. How's everybody doing out there? Oh, it's your hump day program. Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee. So happy we woke up today. How's everybody doing out there? Oh, we got a good one for you today, so sit back, relax, call your friends, tell them to tune in. That's right, because today's show is all about A, woo, F, T, Y, safety. That's right. Today's show is all about being safe and secure and how to do so for little or no money, because that's what we want to do. We want to show you how to enhance your life without breaking the budget, right? You're listening to a song that was put together by my friend DJ Kavum, but singing are me and my three children. This was in the mid-90s, about 20 years ago. I wrote and recorded this song with a gentleman by the name of Keith Lee. S-A-F-E-T-Y. A lot of people don't know I'm an award-winning safety teacher. I taught seatbelt safety in the school system in Atlanta, Georgia, and won a Buckle Up America Award. Safety, safety. Safety, hey, hey, hey. That's right, S-A-F-E-T-Y. Are you being safe? Are you doing everything that you can to protect your life, your home, your vehicle, your possessions, your children, your family? Well, I'm obsessed with it, I think, a little bit. So we're going to talk about that today. And on the phone is my good friend, Lisa. Hey, Lisa.
Hey, you.
All right, let me fade this on out, girl. Safety. S-A-F-E-T-Y. S-A-F-E-T-Y.
S-A-F-E-T-Y.
Safety.
S-A-F-E-T-Y. Safety. Safety.
I love that so much. Yes, indeedy. Safety. Huh? Okay, hold on. My guy's telling me something here. Can you hear me? Okay. All right, we're going to get this thing together here. Lise, you there? Hold on. All right. My girl, Lisa McGrew, you on the phone?
I am here. I can hear you.
Okay, yeah, it's really low. I'm going to turn you up a little bit. How's that?
Well, you probably always need to turn me up because I don't have a very strong voice.
Well, check your phone. Are you turned up all the way on your phone? Is your volume all the way up?
I'm doing it right now.
Okay, great, because I got you blasting, girl. But anyway, it's all good. Okay, thank you. Yeah, he says we're all good now. Hello, world. Welcome to Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee. Again, today the topic of the show is safe and secure. And, of course, I've got my girl, my frugal, happy bestie on the phone, Lisa McGrew. And at the 11:35 hour, we're going to have Michael Kindle, who is a security specialist, who is going to be on the show and talk about ways to protect our home. But, you know, I of course, every week we change the topic of the show. But I have to say, this one was kind of important to me, safe and secure, and I wanted to be sure that we did a show on it because I think there's some common sense things that we can do. You know, the world is changing and people are so nonchalant and, you know what I mean, people are losing their minds. I mean, you know, I just don't know how else to say it. People are... I don't know what's happening with the world. Now, in saying that, I want you to know that I actually do believe that the good outweighs the bad. Wouldn't you say that, Lisa, the good outweighs the bad before we start this whole thing?
I believe that in the bottom of my heart.
Yeah, so, you know, the good outweighs... Oh, it was my volume. Lise?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, man, it was my volume that was turned down. See there? You just got to figure these things out. Okay, great. That was my phone because I'm using my own personal phone. There's my girl. Okay, so we don't want to be doomed. We're not doomsdayers, okay? But at the same time, I think that there's some common sense things that we can do to protect ourselves, you know? And I don't know if any of you have ever had your home broken into or ever been violated or bullied, but it is a horrible, horrible feeling. Wouldn't you agree with that, Lise?
I agree. And it has happened to me.
It happened to me, too. Tell me about your experience.
Yes. It was when we lived in Oregon and, somebody staked out lots of houses in our neighborhood and was they had staked it out and knew when people were going to be home or not home, mm-hmm. and the break-in took place during the day while people were at work, and they hit about 5 homes all in one day, and they took some really personal, very, very personal items out of my home that, not televisions and things that you can replace. They took tools that you can replace those. They took a lot of personal things as well that just really upset me. Mm-hmm. And it made me feel unsafe afterwards.
Right, because it takes away your feeling of self being, your well-being, your feeling of well-being. Mm-hmm. And also, you know, there's nothing better than your home, or should be for most people. And we, of course, we want it that way for everyone. But your home, it should be your castle, your safe place. And then when you walk in that door, I remember when my home got broken into. As soon as I turned the lock, the hairs on the back of my neck stood up. And I don't even know if I have hairs on the back of my neck, but if they were there, they stood up. I just had a feeling. As soon as I walked in, it just, something fell off. You know, something felt off. And then I started looking around, and then I started noticing that things were gone. And then when I walked into my kitchen, the back door, I had one of those stopper things that you could buy. It was from a company called Quorum at that time, which is no longer existent. But I had one of those. You stick it up. It's like a chair, but you stick it under your doorknob. Under your doorknob, and it's supposed to stop the door from opening. Well, it didn't work. This person kicked in my back door, and he took things like a fax machine that I had just gotten. And this was back in the 90s, folks, when, you had your fax machine. You were the shit. I don't know how else to say it. I was so proud of my fax machine. My friend Gary gave me for Christmas. My fax machine was gone. He took coats, which, if you all know me, any coat that I had probably came from the thrift store. But, of course, these were all things that I loved, you know. So, you know, and I just remember, of course, I was a single parent at that time living with my 3 daughters. I think we spent the night somewhere else that night. But then after a while, you have to go home. What else can you do? You can't really leave home because you don't feel secure, you know. So anyway, it's a terrible feeling. It's a terrible feeling. And I know when I was a teenager, I'm just going to confess it right here and now, I actually took something when I was 11 years old, and I was babysitting, and I saw a trinket in someone's thing. And so it was probably karma, even though the lady knew instantly that I had taken it, and she came right to my house. So it was probably karma for me. You know, I'm sorry, lady, wherever you are all of these years later, I'm so, so sorry. But, It is a terrible feeling to be violated in that way. So we wanted to talk about what are some of the no-nonsense things that you can do to protect yourself. We have an expert coming on here a little while later that's going to talk more about home security. But Lisa's just going to tell you how to find our great board on Pinterest.
Yeah, so a lot of, I would say the majority of the things that we're going to talk about today, we have provide a link for you to them so that you can go and find them afterwards or during the show. And you go to Pinterest.com and you're going to find Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee, and she has a board called Safe and Secure, and there are links to everything from today's show.
Yes, I'm looking at this board right now. You know, this is a fun thing. You know, when we started the show, and we'll actually have our one-year anniversary on the 20th of January, that we've been here on KUHS doing this show, I was staying far away from Pinterest because I knew it was fabulous, and I didn't want to get more caught up than I am. I'm a web designer. I do graphic design for people, so I spend a lot of time on the computer, and I have a Facebook addiction. So I spend a lot of time on the computer, and I just didn't want to get drawn into Pinterest. So it was so great that Lisa was the Pinterest pal. That's what we called her. Because she would go on and find these things. But in the midst of it, between, you know, our kickoff and now, I got pulled in. And I got to say, I truly, truly, truly love this. I really love it. It's just an easy way to pull together all of the bloggers and articles and all of those things. So on our board, Safe and Secure, you might find 25 to 30 different articles on how to survive, or 25 to 30 different articles on kids' safety, internet safety, and how to get out of a zip tie and how to break out of a trunk and, you know, all of these different things. But they're so great. And everybody's got a different take on it. And there's some that are very lighthearted. And then we have some pins on here that are from some serious, hardcore survivalists. Okay. And I love those too, because I'm reading up on everything. I don't know if it's because I love the sci-fi kind of movies, but movies like The Terminator, movies like 2012. And if you haven't seen 2012, I think everybody should watch that movie, because it's all about, of course, we've passed that time, but it's all about, you know, the world is coming to an end and everybody is preparing for it. And, you know, mentally, everybody's coming to grips with it. And, of course, the rich and elite are going to, you know, be able to live because they have the money to buy themselves, you know, buy their way into freedom. But the rest of us, the other 99% of us, you know, we have to prepare. And I think that's true. I think that the world is crazy. I think we don't know what's in store for 2017. I think you got to have some common sense tools in your hand. And so we're just going to jump right in. And I'm going to say the very first common sense thing to me, and having read all of this, is lock your door. And it is just amazing. I was telling Lisa that, you know, depending on where you live, you might live in a neighborhood where you are so comfortable. But I guess because of the fact that I am on the computer so much and I surf the computer to find information to post on the Making Away with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee Facebook page, I see a lot of stories where people just, you know, like one I posted about a guy who woke up to hear his little daughter crying, and he goes in there and there's some drunk guy sitting in his living room holding his daughter. Well, if his door had been locked, the man who mistakenly went into his home would never have opened that door. But you hear all the time about people who are normally feeling very safe, and all of a sudden some asshole comes in your garage, you know, is able to get into the house of your garage, or comes in and walks in. Or, you know, if you look at also on here, we have lots of articles about from thieves saying, you know, this is what we look for. And the first thing, the number one thing on every list, is all they do is walk around to find an open door or window. So I would say the very first thing is lock your door. Now, what do you have to contribute to that, Lisa? What do you think?
Well, absolutely. And when our house was broken into, they took a tool from outside and smashed in a window, and no doors were unlocked, but locking your door is huge. And I guess I've been one of those people. I lived in Alaska and I didn't ever lock my door. Mm-hmm. And when I've lived in these really little tiny rural places, I haven't worried about it, but anytime I've been in a town or a city, I'm a lot more vigilant. And my number one thing if I always have a dog, and no, I don't need a German Shepherd watchdog or some kind of, you know, kind of dog like that, but, you know, like a Labrador Retriever, just any dog, even a small dog that tends to bark, mm-hmm. it makes you feel safe every time there's a sound or a movement or something,
right.
Your dog barks and alerts you. And I love having dogs. First of all, I love dogs, but I also feel safe with a dog in the house, mm-hmm. Whether I'm there or not.
Right, and that was also on the top of the list, you know? Burglars, people who are watching your home or what, they don't want to deal with your animal. So
mm-hmm. no.
That was also at the very top of the list. Well, when we come back, I'm going to play a song here. And when we come back, we're going to jump right into some things that you can do for personal safety and start reading a little bit more, give you more survival tips and whatnot. But I did want to share our own stories because, you know, this is something that touches everyone. I don't care where you live. If you live in a great neighborhood, and like Lisa says, you could be living rural, but you just never know that person that's, you know, that's counting on that, that's going, these people, I know that these people in these rural neighborhoods, you know, don't lock their doors. But I'm going to also add that in the rural neighborhoods, that people are more likely to be armed. And I read a lot of articles about that, too, about people who are breaking into homes and losing their lives. They're losing their lives because they're messing with other people's properties. And more and more people, you know, we're gun happy here in the United States. I think we have more guns here than in the world. So watch your back in whatever you're doing. But when we come back, we're going to just talk more about safety. You're listening to Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee and Lisa McGrew. Here's a song by Robin Thicke. It's called Lock the Door. Here we go.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. Sha na na na, 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 sha na na na. 1, 2, look at you. 3, 4, she locked the door. I keep knocking, 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 knocking. She was born in Paris at the age of 21. Love knew her, but she didn't know love. Love didn't hear her when she cried. Love didn't stand by her side on the most important night. Oh yeah. But now she's flying high. You can't hurt her no more. And now she's locked the door, 'cause you broke the key. And she got a bright smile on her face. Now that she got a little taste, she just wants more. She just wants more. She locked the door.
I kept trying to tell you, you were pushing me too far.
She locked the door.
I kept trying to warn you, you were slowly breaking my heart.
She locked the door.
I kept giving you all up, and when you took me.
She locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it,
locked
it. 1, 2, look at you. 3, 4, she locked the door. I keep knocking, 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 knocking. Hey! One morning the tears started rolling down her empty face. That sparkle in her eye had been abruptly replaced. When I touched her, she said, wait. When I kissed her, she pulled away, and I knew it was over. 'Cause she had nothing left to say. And now she's flying high. You can't hurt her no more. And now she's locked the door, 'cause you broke the key. Now a world without you she calls home. She ain't leaving no post light on. She just wants more. She just wants more. She locked the door.
I kept trying to tell you, you were pushing me too far.
She locked the door.
I kept trying to warn you, you were slowly breaking my heart.
She locked the door.
I kept giving you all up, and when you took way too much.
She locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked
it. I know this ain't love.
1, 2, look at you.
3, 4, she locked the door. I keep knocking, 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 and knocking. Baby, let me in, yeah. Oh, baby, I miss my best friend. Yes, I do. She locked the door.
Lock that door, honey. You lock that door. No door.
She locked it, locked it, locked it, locked it, locked that door. Hey, yeah, woo! Come on, yeah, yeah.
Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee.
She locked the door.
Today's topic is safe and secure, and we're looking at ways to just protect your body. And you know, I like to play a song that goes with the topic, and that was so perfect. Just sending some love to Robin Thicke, of course. You know, 2016 has been, oh man, it's been a year this year. We have had so many great people to pass away this year. And of course, just the other day, Robin's father, Alan Thicke, who, I mean, he's had more of a impact on our lives than we know, because I know he wrote several really popular theme songs. He, of course, was on Growing Pains, one of my favorite songs from back in the day. Bye, Robin. Thanks, man. Okay. Yes, indeedy. So, but Alan Thicke passed away, so it's kind of apropos that I play that song by Robin Thicke. But it's all about locking the door, and it's all about being safe. That's what we want you to do. We want you to be safe. And on the phone is my buddy, Frugal Happy Lisa McGrew, and we've got some great tips for how to keep yourself personally safe. I just want to say that my youngest child lives in New York City. Uh-oh, wait a minute.
This is Lisa on Making a Way. We'll be right back on KUHSDenver.com.
Don't you love listening to yourself, Lisa? All right. So now we are back. But I wanted to say, my daughter lives in New York City, and this week, for the very first time, she had someone that was following her. He followed her 4 or 5 blocks, and then when he got into the train station, he continued to harass her. She went from one end to the other, back to the other. He kept following her. Finally, she started screaming, and she's like me. She's got a huge voice. She started screaming for him to leave her alone and just drew the attention of other people, but she ended up having to pepper spray him. And then some of the other pedestrians held him down until the police came. But the thing that's so interesting about that is that she was prepared. And I'm so happy that she was prepared, that she had pepper spray with her. So I guess luck, as one of my favorite lines from the movie The Incredibles, is when Edna says, luck favors the prepared. Yeah, and so I'm so happy, one, that my baby is all right, and that people cared enough to get involved, and that this guy, you know, is going to suffer some repercussions for what he did, which was to mess with someone that didn't want to be bothered. So anyway, luck favors the prepared. Lisa, jump right on in with some great ideas for personal safety.
Yes, indeed. I have been looking at some different blogs and things like that. One that I read about is from Backdoor Survival Blog, and this person definitely recommends that, you know, we're all going to install lights on our house. He says that we should be installing motion sensor lights, and also to install them high enough so that burglars can't unscrew them or mess with them. So they need to be installed and high up on the wall. And he also says just what your daughter did. He recommends that you have some sort of spray, whether it's pepper spray or wasp spray, or maybe even a stun gun, which I'm kind of interested in because I'm not interested in guns, but a stun gun for in the home might be something I would consider. And he definitely recommends taking a women's self-defense class if you haven't done that already.
Right.
One thing, I went on to Amazon, and I was just kind of looking at what kind of safety devices they have on Amazon, and I pinned a bunch of them to the board. And one thing that I saw was a safety siren alarm keychain. And it's just something that you hook right onto your keychain, and it's got a big alarm on it. And it just seems like if you're a woman in particular, it might be something if you have a small voice or, you know, you're a small person, it might be something that you would consider picking up. I'm sure there's different brands that you can buy.
Right. Well, but I think we're looking at the same one, Lisa, and I love number four. As a matter of fact, I have a video on YouTube that I did before, you know, this is when I was, because my goal is television, so I started making videos on different things, but one is, this says learn to use tools, and I could not agree, I could not agree more. Learn to use tools, you know what I mean? And one of the suggestions it says here is that, you know, go to YouTube, and it's so correct. Anything you need to know how to fix, trust me, somebody has a YouTube video on it. But it's just good to know how to repair things so that, you know, you can be self-reliant, you know, and that you can, and also I think it's good to just have tools. I know I like to keep weapons in each room. I know I might be a little paranoid here, but, you know, I think it's good to I have several hammers, you know, in case you need to go upside somebody's head. I mean, you know, you just never know when you have to protect yourself. But anyway, I just really love that one, learn to use tools. And I have a video, again, on YouTube, if you look under Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee, and I have a video there on all of the tools that I get. And because I shop secondhand and because I'm a garage sale and a flea market shopper, I have a very impressive toolkit. And I'm also an interior redesigner, so I need them. But I like being self-reliant. I'm a person, I can change my own tires. I can, you know, I like to be able to fix things. When stuff falls apart, I like to pull my tools out, look up. If I don't know, look up how to repair them before I bring a stranger into the house. Okay, go ahead, Lisa.
There's another website called Survival Life, and they talk about when answering your door, they recommend that you definitely have the person identify themselves. Mm-hmm. Use your peephole if you have one. And also just make sure you're using your gut feeling. If something feels funny about it, don't open the door.
Right.
And, another thing they recommend is that if you want to, just have the person hold tight and call the company and make sure that the person really was called out, whether it's a plumber or a garage door fixer or whatever the case is, but just, you know, use your gut feelings and be safe.
And can I say, I love that one because a lot of people want to be polite. Some people are so concerned about being polite. Oh, I don't want to make the person wait outside too long. But if they're there legitimately, they won't mind waiting there. Long as they know that you're home and it's not a missed appointment, if they're there legitimately and you have concerns, I love that advice. Call the company and make sure that it is who they say they are. Because I also posted an article about people who have been someone robbed a home showing up wearing a UPS outfit. Well, you know, particularly if you're a secondhand shopper, or you go to a uniform store, you can buy pretty much anything you want. So anyway, follow your first gut. I couldn't agree more. Okay, go ahead, Liz.
Okay, I went to simplysafe.com, and they say, well, what do you do if you're home when someone is breaking into your home? Well, they definitely recommend that you keep quiet and don't let them know where you are. Get away and call 911 so that someone's on the way. And if you can't leave the house without them finding you out, they say that you should hide in a room and with a door that can lock, and you wait it out. And this particular Simply Safe recommends, don't even mess with the tools, the weapons, like if you were to have a gun or something like that, because if the burglar sees that you have a weapon, it could escalate and actually get worse, and they recommend these other things are probably going to keep you safe, more safe than just getting out your weapon.
Well, I think most people have a weapon to protect themselves at home. And I know that if I hear somebody coming in and I have a weapon, I'm absolutely coming out shooting. And then there's always a chance, because you also hear stories about, you know, the child was sneaking back in the house and parents who have accidentally shot, you know, a family member or something like that. But I think that the majority of the people who have a weapon are not going to listen to that, because that's why they're not buying the weapons to go out and rob and steal. They're buying the weapons to protect themselves and their home. So if you're going to have it and you've taken it and you've gone out and you've learned how to shoot it, you know how to work the weapon, I say, why not get loud? Get the hell out of here. I got a gun. I promise you, I've called the police. I will use it. Get out of here. I don't know. I think the squeaky wheel gets the oil. But, you know, again, these blogs and these different articles are people's opinions, professional opinions. And I'll ask my specialist when he comes on here about that. What are his thoughts on that? But I think that 90% of the people who have a weapon buy it to protect themselves at home. So why would you then not grab it and run and hide? I don't know. That doesn't make sense to me.
Well, and you may be one of those folks that has a gun in the house. We don't have a gun in our house, and I don't think we intend to get a gun. But as I said earlier, I would consider, my mom has, she uses wasp spray. She has some there, and I might get some pepper spray, or I might even get a stun gun, because I'm quite certain that we're not going to have a gun in our home. But, you know, those other ideas, I would go for those personally. So, each person has to make up their mind about what's right in their home.
Right.
So I wanted to, I know we're going to run out of time. If we have time, I wanted to jump to one more
thing.
I was reading about. Yeah, I was reading about, like, let's say you're out in the community. Mm-hmm. Well, there's a woman, she calls herself momwithaprep.com, and she says that you're out in the community. She recommends that, say you're feeling unsafe, like maybe your daughter in New York City. She says, definitely get off your cell phone and be vigilant of your surroundings. Don't be on your phone.
That's right.
And then she says, she recommends either don't carry a purse, or if you are, as a woman, going to carry a purse. Now, a lot of men in Europe have bags as well. They're saying either don't carry one, or don't leave your purse or your bag unattended, because that attracts people, thieves to you, that type of thing. And again, she's recommending don't be afraid to speak up, just like your daughter in New York City started getting real loud and telling him to get off and attracting attention to her so that people were paying attention. And they're just like, don't try to be polite. Speak up and protect yourself that way.
That's right. And I taught my children that from the time they were children. Teach your children, if they feel scared, to speak up. If they, you know what I mean? And the kids, these kids nowadays, I tell you, they're exposed to more than we were ever exposed to as growing up. And on our Pinterest board, we actually have some great ideas on how to protect the kids on the internet. And trust me, it's happening. And I can tell you that I have a 13-year-old granddaughter, and she is on the internet all the time. And there are people on there who are masquerading as children, again, these chat rooms and all of these different things. Parents, you will never know everything your children have access to on this phone. It is just amazing because they're raised with the internet. It's very commonplace for them. But there are things that you can put on the phone. There are safeguards on the phone that you have already that you don't even know about. You've got to get into your settings and start going around and pushing buttons and checking things out. You already have some fail safeguards on your phone right now, on your TV, on your smartphones. There are ways to keep your kids from surfing. There are ways to alert you if your children are going into certain things. There is so much out there. But talk to your children about internet safety. And again, talk to them about walking around with both headphones on, both earbuds in. It's crazy. People are getting killed. There are more pedestrian deaths than ever from people just walking, blaring their music, not paying attention, and they're walking right out. You know, you're thinking about your music, you're singing. I have begged my daughter in New York not to walk around with both earbuds in, to take one out. And so, of course, when this happened in New York, I you know, maybe I shouldn't have, but I used this as a way to say, see, didn't I tell you? And, you know. But anyway, these are just, there's a lot of really common sense things. Again, we fortify your home, you know, make sure that you plan. You know, again, luck favors the prepared. Prepare yourself. prepare yourself in your car for if your car breaks down. Have a blanket in there. I do. Have tools in there. I do. I found a fabulous flashlight. I was trying to find it. I know this flashlight is older, but it had a window breaker on it. It had a seatbelt. It has a seatbelt cutter. It has an alarm. It has a magnet to put it on. I was trying to find it online, and it's not there because this is something that was sitting in someone's home, and when they purged, they gave it to the thrift store. I bought it for 99 cents, and it is my favorite thing that I found all year. I love it.
I know where you can buy that. I know where you can buy one of those.
Yeah.
Yep, it's called e-bags, and like they sell a lot of luggage and suitcase and things for cars and travelers, and I've seen them on there, and they're really cool.
Okay, great. And again, Google, you know, I'm a great lover. Of course, we love Pinterest, but I'm a great lover of Google as well. Go on there, look at what they've got, and, you know, and type in personal safety flashlights, and it'll send you to all of the websites that sell them. But anyway, there's so much great information, and we could go on and on, but I'm going to go ahead and go to commercial so that I can get my guest on the phone. But again, Lisa, thank you again for this board. Pinterest, look up Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee. The board is safe and secure. We've got 200 and some pins. I mean, it is fabulous. Something for everything, but prepare yourself. Don't be the sheep. Don't be the person that just thinks, you know what I mean? Of course, I'm a believer in God and angels and all that stuff. And, oh, I'm covered by the blood of Jesus and I don't have to worry about. Well, you know what? The thing is, it's good to be practical. Okay? So, think about what you're doing. Think about how you're doing it. Don't broadcast to everybody that you live alone. Don't broadcast that you're going out of town. You know, it's so easy to do. We're all, you know, we're on Facebook and we're all on the internet. We're so happy about our vacations and whatnot because you have people out there.
Are you a business owner? Have you always wanted to advertise?
Okay, we'll be right back.
Get your advertising going with KUHS Denver and deliver to all the Front Range, to Colorado, to the entire world. We can do it for you from start to finish, complete with a professional commercial, social site presence, and other avenues of advertising. KUHS is now a very successful advertising outlet that brings results for your business or product. Get going today by calling Henry at 303-255-0567. Advertise with KUHSDenver.com today. Call Henry 303-255-0567. Advertise locally, be heard worldwide. Again, give Henry at KUHS Denver a call at 303-255-0567 to advertise with KUHSDenver.com.
And now, back to Making a Way with Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I got caught up there in the commercial. Oh, my goodness. Well, you know, there's always so much to say. I guess, what was I talking about there at the end? I was running my mouth real good. Oh, I'm looking in here. We got listeners listening in from New Zealand and Indonesia, Mexico, Canada. Oh, we're so happy. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And no matter where you are in the world, you know, we want you to use common sense and protect yourself with the way that you need to. But on the line right now.
Girls, kick butt.
On the line right now, hello, is my security specialist, Michael Kindle. How you doing, Michael?
Doing pretty good. Doing pretty good. How you doing, Miss Sheryl Renee?
Okay, good. Well, I just want everybody to know, as you know, if you listen to my show, you know that I hire my friends. I hire people that I know and care and love about. And on the phone is someone who I share children and grandchildren with. It's my ex-husband, Michael Kindle, but I have him on because he has been in the security business forever. He works for ADT. He has his own security company. And I have him on the phone to talk about safety. How you doing?
Doing pretty good. How you doing?
Okay, great. Okay, so we are talking about, now we're going to shift the conversation to home safety. And of course, I just mentioned that Michael works for ADT and he has his own business where he sells cameras and different things. But, you know, what are some of the no-nonsense ways to protect and secure your home?
Okay. Well, first, let me correct that. I just work for ADT now.
Okay.
But the first thing I want to say, before you do anything, you have to, and I'm just going to piggyback off some of the things that you said, you have to have a mindset that it can happen to you. If you go outside in the rain, you're going to get rained on.
Right.
That's why the Creator came up with an umbrella. So, you know, you have to do certain things. It starts with your mind, the mindset of saying that, hey, it can happen to me. So the first thing I like to say, you know, you just have to change your mindset and realize that things can happen to you.
Mm-hmm.
And Cheryl, you wanted me to pretty much talk about home protection.
Mm-hmm.
I want to just share two things that I told my daughters when they were growing up, and then I'll go into the home protection side of. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you very well. Are you walking?
I was walking. I just came from a networking event. I apologize.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So now, for all the women out there, one thing I used to tell my daughter, and I tell a lot of my female friends, is that if you're ever in the house and you're alone and you're confronted by a burglar or a person that's bigger than you, one of the things I told my girls is that get your iron, wrap it around your hand and put it behind your back, and you know, it makes you a lot, your punch is a lot more impactful than his.
So have a weapon, you know? Basically.
Yeah, and the iron is one of the weapons. I want to say also, weapons are good, but your mind is the strongest weapon that you would have. We're going to talk about things that you can do for home safety, but just remember, your mind is the strongest weapon that you can have, and I'm not going to elaborate on that. Later on, I'll give people my email address, and if they want to get some more information out, I'll go into fire safety and child safety, and I'll just send out an email blast with a lot of different things. But when it comes to protecting your home, I guess one of the main things is, you know, your first line of defense is actually going to be locking all your doors, making sure that your doors are locked.
Mm-hmm.
By spending a few dollars. Now, criminals, people don't realize that a lot of break-ins happen when people are at home. So when I go out and talk to people and they tell me, well, you know, somebody's always here, I tell them, look, that's even more the reason that you should have a security system.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, lock your front door. On your windows, if you don't have an alarm, you can put window pins. If you have wooden windows, you can go to Home Depot or Lowe's, and they're not that expensive, $2 or $3. You know, make sure you have dead bolts. You know, your peepholes, make sure you have a 180-degree peephole that gives you the advantage of checking to see what's at the door before you open. And then when it comes to people just moving in, don't pull a lot of your boxes out, you know,
showing
what you have, like you have a TV box and different things like that.
Right, because you have people who are driving around and looking, and
looking
you put out, and particularly after Christmas, tear those boxes up. You know what I mean?
Just,
don't advertise what you've brought into your home.
Yeah, at late at night, if you're gonna put them out, take a something and just cut the boxes up,
mm-hmm.
and you know, don't, so they won't see what you're actually putting out. And then the main thing when you're moving into a new home is, I would always recommend to change all the locks on your doors. You know, that's going to be something that's very, very important, because you never know who has a key, who's lived there before.
Right.
And so I would definitely change all the locks on your doors.
Okay.
Now,
can we talk a little bit about alarms? Can we talk about why you feel like people, and I just want to say, I do have an alarm system, and I'm very happy. You know, I feel it gives me some peace of mind. You know, and yes, I pay a monthly fee, but can you go into why maybe people should consider getting an alarm system?
Okay. Well, the main reason why you should consider getting an alarm is because one of my worst fears was that if I'm at home sleeping, I wake up and somebody's standing over me.
Right.
And, you know, I don't have a dog or anything like that. The best combination is a dog and an alarm, but there's so many things that they can do to, you know, disarm your dogs. But the main reason you want an alarm is because it deters a criminal,
mm-hmm.
it detects a criminal, and it delays a criminal. So you want to know, even if you got a gun, even if you got a weapon, you want to be ready when somebody's coming in. And an alarm is going to help you be ready when you when somebody's coming in your home. With an alarm, you know, they're very, very easy to use. What most people don't realize is that when you're going to be attacked, some people wait till you're entering your home. When you have an alarm, we have what you call a hostage arrest code, where if you're going in and somebody comes behind you, puts a gun on you, and forces you in your home, you have the opportunity to turn your alarm off, but at the same time notify your monitoring company that you're in a situation. So for the people that don't have an alarm, if somebody forces you in, you don't have any way of letting anybody know that you need help.
Right.
Another thing is police, ambulance, and fire emergency buttons on your alarm system.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody's trying to get in your house, and I talk to some people and they say, oh, man, your alarm goes off and it takes the police forever to come out. It only takes the police a long time to come out if you call and say, I've been burglarized, and then they know you already been burglarized. It may take their time coming out, but on your alarm system, you have a panic button
mm-hmm.
that if you hit this panic button, it will, the police puts it in a whole nother category. They'll come out right away.
Right.
I mean, it's like it jumps from like a burglary to a home invasion or a bank robbery.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have that panic button, then, you know, you can notify the police will come out immediately. And the way the alarm systems work is this. When your alarm goes off, the security company calls your home. And if you don't answer, then what they do is hang up, call police dispatch in your area. And the closest police in your area is going to be notified. That's a possibly alarm. So if the police is right around the street or a couple of blocks away,
mm-hmm.
they will come to your house.
And not only but I also get, like, if my alarm goes off and don't catch it in time, I get a text, which is really great.
Absolutely. That's what we call our pulse system. Home alarms are now going to more than just burglary alarm system. We have alarms that, hey, if you forget to turn your alarm off, the alarm will automatically set itself at 10 o'clock at night. You can set the alarm to where it will automatically set itself at mm-hmm. 10. It'll automatically turn itself off. If you walk your dog at 8 o'clock, it'll automatically turn itself off at 8 o'clock. Turn itself off at 8 o'clock and re-alarm itself at 8:15. Also, we have alarms that if somebody kicks in your door,
mm-hmm.
you can have your alarm set up to where it will send you a video clip of the person who's coming in your home.
I think is one of the best thing that's happening with the new alarm systems. Because, of course, right now, this time of year, you got a lot of people who are stealing packages off of porches. And it's so amazing because with the motion detector part of the alarms, and also more and more footage is popping up on the internet showing people, you know, this person, can you identify this person? And there you are. You think you're so slick because you've walked up to somebody's door to steal the packages, which is incredible to me that now UPS and the post office will leave your package on your porch. I just think that's so terrible. I think they didn't used to do that, but now that's the norm. If you're not there, your package is going to get left on the porch. So, but now you've got the cameras that will do that. And also another thing I like about the alarm system are the motion detectors. You know, you can set your alarm to be to stay or away, but you push stay, and while you're in the house, you know, your motion detector's on. Of course, this is not good if you have a pet, though, right?
Yeah, well, if your pet is under We have pet immune motion detectors that if your pet is under 60 pounds, it won't pick it up. But now keep in mind, if your pet jumps up on your couch and that motion detector is in line of sight of that couch, when the pet moves, it looks like a head of an elephant is moving. So the motion detector will actually pick up the whole couch.
Mm-hmm.
What we do in place of motion detectors, some people have, especially cats, because they will jump everywhere. You can go in you can install what we call glass breakers.
Mm-hmm.
And what a glass breaker does, it picks up the sound of glass. It's a dual tech device that picks up the sound of glass being broken. It picks up the thud and the screeching part. You know, the old glass breaks just picked up one level, but now this is a dual tech that picks up two levels.
Okay, so, this is great. Now, we don't have much time, but I did want to ask you this question. Do you think dummy things work? And when I say dummy, like, you know, if you can't afford a camera, to buy a broken camera and put it up, or, you know what I mean, to put a beware of dog sign in the window, or, you know, me, as you know, I have 80 ticks. When they come to my house, I'm like, give me 20 stickers. I have a sticker on every window, as well as the sign in front that says I have ADT. But every window in the basement has a sticker on it. And do you think those things help?
Absolutely. And that goes back to me saying that your mind is the strongest weapon that you have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, anything that you can do to deter a criminal, you know, saying that, you know, I have a monitored camera system, or I have a dog, or whatever you can do to, you know, throw a criminal off, I think you should do it. But I just believe 100% in burglar alarms, because whatever situation you're in, you might be a good fighter if you're a male, or, you know, you want the police to be coming around that corner, because if you're not a professional fighter, you're probably not going to last more than 1 or 2 minutes,
right?
Especially if it's a group of people. So alarms are worth their weight in gold. We have so many situations or stories where actually, you know, ADT alarms or alarms, period, just save people's lives.
Right.
I just believe that the company I work for is the best.
Okay.
But
and I do have ADT. I'm going to put it out there. This is not a commercial for them. But since I do have the ADT guy on the phone, we'll go ahead and say that. But also, I want to say, you know, you get a discount. You get a discount on your insurance, on your home insurance, on your renter's insurance. You get a discount if you have an alarm, even on your car insurance.
Not only do you get a discount, what we do, if you're burglarizing, we're the only company that if you have renter's insurance or homeowner's insurance, we will cut you up to a $500 check in the event that you're burglarized. And most people won't do that. So if you're burglarized, of course, your homeowner's and renter's insurance will pay for the things that's stolen, but you still have a deductible.
Right.
And we will pay up to a $500 of your homeowner's insurance deductible. Homeowners or renters insurance deductible if you're burglarized. And if anybody's interested in help, I can help people nationwide with a security system.
Okay. Well, tell the people how they can contact you, how they can reach you.
Okay. You can reach me by phone at 678.
Well, give your email address, would you?
Okay. My email address is mkindle like the fire, KINDLE, at ADT.com. mkindle, KINDLE, at ADT.com.
Okay.
AppleDeltaTom.com.
All right. Well, Michael, thank you so much for coming on the show, and just for being a great friend and also being a great father and grandfather. I just throw that in there before you get off.
No problem. I appreciate you. Anytime you need my help, just let me know.
All right. Thanks again.
All right.
Okay.
Have a good time. Bye-bye.
All right. Well, you know, we try to cover the stuff on here. That was some great advice for protecting your home. I'm looking at this board that we have, again, Safe and Secure. We have over 25 to 30 articles on how to protect your home from common sense security. Here's one that talks about 7 common home security mistakes. If you want to go on here and see the things that you're probably doing wrong that you need to adjust, you can go on there for that. You know, we've got articles here from burglars on what they look for and what to do. We've got lots of boards on here on different self-defense things that you can do to help protect your life. And I'm really for that. Some of the weak things, remember the, you know, palm strikes. The nose is a sensitive area. The knees are a sensitive area. The thumb, anytime somebody grabs you and you need to get away, you want to push down on that thumb. That thumb is the weakest part of the hand. I mean, we could just go on and on and on here, but there are so many great things. And again, because this is Bargain Queen show, hello, I wanted to talk about this one. I love this one from UrbanSurvivalSite.com. UrbanSurvivalSite.com. 25 prepper items to look for at flea markets and thrift stores. Hello! And of course, I told you if you were listening earlier, you know, we've got information on here for those who are just looking to protect themselves, all the way to those who are looking at how to survive a calamity. And I'm that person. I've started collecting things to survive a calamity. Okay, I want to know how to protect myself in the event that something goes down. I think it's so important that we do that. You know, the world is crazy. It could be a natural disaster. It doesn't even have to be about, you know, people and what they're doing. Of course, any of you know, any kind of natural disaster could happen. But some of the things here it says to look for are boots, winter gear, cookware, candles, manual kitchen tools. You've got to have a manual can opener. You know, if that is so important. Blankets. I can tell you right now, I will never again in life throw away a blanket. I was in New York when Hurricane Sandy hit. We were without power for 6 days. That hurricane happened on, I think, like the 29th of October. It was freezing, and I could not get enough blankets. The blankets saved me, and I thought, you know what? People don't think about it. You know, your blanket gets old or tattered or whatnot, and you think, I'm going to give it away. Nope. Fold it up, put it up, get you a space bag, suck the air out of it, put that sucker up. Hold on to all the blankets that you can get, because in the event of an emergency, not only are you going to need a blanket to cover yourself, but you're going to need maybe a covering to lay on the floor, something to make a tent for yourself. So anyway, I am a firm believer in blankets. Camping gear. You want to have camping gear. I'm finding at thrift stores and garage sales, you know, everything that I can get, you know, little portable barbecue things, little whatever you can get. Lanterns, tools, fishing gear, hunting gear, buckets and barrels. And, you know, and this is just, you want to go and buy one of those big buckets from Home Depot or Lowe's or whatnot, because these will make a portable potty in the event that you need it. And I'm a person, I've got a million plastic bags from the grocery store. I'm saving those things. And I'm saving them because you never know when you're going to use them. And one of the things that, you know, you get one of these buckets and you use those to make a portable toilet. Hey, you know, you just never know. Food preservation supplies like canning, backpacks. You know, if you have to hike, you know, you're going to need them. Hold on to your backpacks. Find a place where you can store them. Flashlights, radios. I love this. Board games, cards, and books. You know, you're going to have to keep yourself entertained when there's no power. You got kids, you know, trying to think of things to do. Gardening supplies like shovels and different things like that. You just never know. Towels or rags, wood cutting equipment, yards of fabric. Again, that goes back to the blankets, you know, because blankets are just big pieces of fabric when it comes down to it. Sewing supplies, medical equipment. And here's one I wanted to give a tip of the week, but just because I'm about to run out of time, people don't know that cayenne pepper is a survivalist thing that you want to have in your backpack, because it will stop bleeding. It restricts the blood vessels. If you have a severe wound, you pour that cayenne pepper there and it will stop the bleeding. Just different things like this to know. So anyway, again, rain gear, knives. Oh, this is such a great article. And you can find more great articles on our Pinterest page at Bargain Queen You want to go to Pinterest.com, Pinterest.com. You want to go to Bargain Queen Sheryl Renee. The name of this board is Safe and Secure. And we have all of our boards on here that can help you. But the main thing is, I didn't want to poo-poo the faith thing because I think it is good to have faith, you know, in what you're doing. You know, when you have faith, you never feel like you're alone. I was going to sing this song, Stand, but I run out of time. But basically, just stand and just stand up for yourself. If you feel threatened, stand up. If you're in a situation, look around. I like to think of the like the movie of, oh man, this music, I can't even think of the music. I'm ready to sing. But basically, stand up for yourself. Look around. When you're in a situation, you know, don't panic. Look around for the escape. Look around for the weapon. Look around for a way to save your life. Ah, okay, I think we got into it. There's so many great self-defense things on here. So, if you must, please go on our board. The groin, ladies, never forget. Men in their balls, okay? The elbow, the throat. Oh, my gosh, there's so many great things on here. Protect yourself. Be safe. We'll be back next Wednesday. Our show is all going to be a wrap. We're going to look around the world, stories around the world. Because this will be our last show for 2016. It's been an incredible year. It's been a sad year. I want to say goodbye to President and Michelle Obama here in the United States. 8 wonderful years as far as I'm concerned. Nobody's perfect, and I know, you know, but man, I'm so proud of them and the leaders that they have been for our country. So to all of our visitors from around the world, we just thank you for tuning in. We'll be back next week. Bye-bye.